Old plane versus new plane. What's actually cheaper? You think a private airplane is like a yacht without water. Expensive, flashy, and totally unnecessary. And if you ever buy one, obviously used, cheaper, right? Now pay attention. A brand new four-seat airplane with modern avionics and a 200-knot cruise from 78,000 euros. Yes. 78. No, it's not a typo. No, it's not 1983. This is 2026, right now. It's cheaper than your boring, fully loaded crossover, and it flies like a budget business jet. In this video, I'll show you why a new airplane today can be smarter, cheaper, and safer than an old one, and why more and more pilots are choosing exactly this path. Yes, this video is about airplanes, but if you look closer, it's really about freedom. Why a new airplane, and not the legendary old one with cherry velour? When you buy an old airplane, you're buying flying archaeology. You don't know if the logbook tells the truth, who flew it and how it was repaired, what broke last time, and how badly. How many times someone said, it'll probably make it. What you do get, corrosion, metal fatigue, electrics designed by people wearing glasses thicker than a helmet. And the worst part? Unexpected downtime. You bought an airplane to fly, but it's parked, waiting for maintenance, waiting for a part, waiting for you to give up. Downtime is when your airplane rests more than you do, and you still pay like it's working full time. A new airplane is different. Zero cycles, clear remaining life, modern materials, predictable maintenance, and most importantly, control. You know exactly what each hour costs, and you know it won't suddenly catch fire, jam up, or ask for just a little more money right before your vacation. Why four seats, not two, not six? Two seats? That's a Sunday joyride. That's me, a GoPro, and the sky. Not versatility. Six seats? An illusion. Because with full fuel, those six seats don't exist. They're in the brochure, not in real life. We'll show the numbers later. If that surprised you, hit like. And in the comments, tell me, how many people actually fly in your plane most of the time? Real flying looks like this. One person, two people, sometimes three, sometimes luggage or family. Four seats is the sweet spot. Family, friends, shared ownership, business, travel, all of it, without absurd costs. Why experimental? And no, this isn't a shed project. For some people, experimental sounds scary, like a flying vacuum cleaner made of plywood. Let's be honest, experimental today means a composite kit aircraft built in a build assist center with proper documentation, modern systems, and sane regulations. This is not backyard madness. This is modern composites, modern engines, advanced avionics, and rules that understand it's not 1978 anymore. Certification is not a synonym for safety. Very often, it's just a synonym for cost, a synonym for delays, and a synonym for, we need 5 more years to confirm aluminum is still aluminum. And here's the fun part. Experimentals are often faster, more efficient, more modern. We already compared certified versus experimental operating costs. The results might surprise you. Link is in the description. Don't miss it. Engine. Rotax versus old school. Lycoming and Continental are old school, like a VHS player. Yes, it works, but you're always turning knobs and praying it doesn't eat the tape. With them, you manually manage mixture, constantly watch EGT, burn 40 liters per 100 miles, and pay for every service like it's a kidney transplant. Rotax 916IS is a different world. Full electronics, automatic engine management, no unnecessary hand dancing. You just fly. The smart engine handles the rest. Power, 160 horsepower for takeoff, 140 horsepower in cruise. More than enough for a light four-seater like Sling or ANG. And the best part? Costs. 2 to 3 times less fuel. Maintenance is dramatically cheaper. No surprises. No headaches. Price, old versus new. A new kit airplane, 390 to 400,000 euros. That gets you Sling TSI, ANG, RV10, Velocity XL. Now open controller and see what 400,000 buys you used. Cirrus SR22, 15 years old. Bonanza, 20 plus years. Cessna, also ancient, with buttons from another era. Same price. But old avionics, unclear history, higher maintenance, and every flight feels like a gamble. Destroying the six-seat myth. Example, Piper M350. Beautiful, heavy, expensive, $2 million. Empty weight, 1,383 kilograms. Max takeoff, 1,969 kilograms. Fuel, 454 liters is 327 kilograms. Remaining payload, 259 kilograms. Translate that into humans. 3 adults at 80 kilograms plus 19 kilograms of bags. That's it. 6 seats? Where? Only on paper. While the Piper carries 3 people and 1 bag, ANG carries 4 adults, 80 kilograms of luggage, and flies 2,500 kilometers for dinner. 5 times cheaper. No tears at the fuel pump. And no, not in a hot air balloon. Short runways? Easy. Comfort? Better. ANG cabin is 10 centimeters wider. Wider than Cirrus. Roomier than Diamond, DA50 and Bonanza. You're not sitting like sardines elbow fighting over armrest territory. Now about money and how not to lose your health. The club model, or how not to burn 400K. On average, one pilot flies 100 to 200 hours per year. The rest of the time, the airplane just sits. That's bad for airplanes. A fully equipped ANG with parachute and full Garmin avionics costs about 390,000 euros. That doesn't mean selling a kidney. It means 5 owners. The airplane flies regularly, doesn't rot on the ramp. You get your 100 to 200 hours per year. And your personal cost? 78,000 euros. Cheaper than a new Mercedes E-Class or a BMW X5. But the difference is massive. At the same money, a car goes 120 to 130 kilometers per hour. An airplane flies 3 times faster. Fuel equivalent? About 10 liters per 100 kilometers when calculated per distance traveled. And you're not on a road. You're above everything. Dinner 1,000 kilometers away? Weekend trips? Every week if you want. Try that by car. You'll hate your life. Final truth. You're not paying for metal. You're paying for the ability to leave every week for places that take others 12 hours to reach. A flying airplane lives. A parked airplane dies and drains your wallet. With shared ownership, hangar costs are shared, maintenance is shared, insurance is shared, flight time is scheduled. Result? Machines stay healthy, engines live longer, airplanes don't become decorative furniture. And yes, monthly costs are lower than your business sedan. So tell me in the comments, would you buy an airplane in shared ownership? Yes or no, and why? One last question. If you had to choose one airplane that delivers on every front, which one is it? ANG, the undisputed leader. We compared the top 10 modern cross-country aircraft across 7 key parameters: speed, range, fuel burn, luggage, ownership cost, reliability, flexibility. ANG won most of them. Watch the full comparison, link below. This is not about status. Yes, an airplane is a luxury, but not to impress your neighbor. Luxury means doing more, seeing more, deciding for yourself where you'll be tomorrow. While others stand in security lines, you fly to the sea for dinner, or just because you feel like it. Your choice is simple. You can keep driving in traffic, or you can fly above it. You can wait for boarding calls, or walk to the runway and take off. The question isn't the price. The question is, are you living or just commuting? If you want the airplane that makes this possible, you already know its name. ANG. Reserve yours now.